to be happening in the short term? Is this a level that bargain hunters are watching out for? Some analysts have said it's actually time to be entering now while we're in this ECQ. Or are, as you know, and some of the risks have already been priced. You already mentioned the GDP print that came out. There's, of course, the BSP decision also. But then, you know, you, like you mentioned, there's also a barrage of earnings that have already come out, and perhaps these extensions to the ECQ have already priced in. Is this time to be entering the market?
Well, for if we're going to look at the market from a technical standpoint, for me, it's not yet a good time to it's not yet a good time to come into the market right now. If you're into a long term, perhaps you can do some accumulation, but limit your buying. The best time to enter the market would still be at strongly determined support levels. So right now, if you're going to look at the market, sadly, it went below 6,600. So it wasn't able to sustain its ground at that level. That is a determined, for us, that's a determined resistance level. Since it wasn't able to sustain its ground at 6,600, I believe it's best for us to wait and see if the market would be able to confirm its next support, which is at 6,400. Okay, if the market is able to hold its ground at 6,400, then that could be a good time for us to hunt for some bargains. There is something worrisome about the market, however, and that is if you're going to plot its 50-day and its 200-day exponential moving average, it's about to cross again, meaning the 50-day exponential moving average is about to cross below the 200, its 200-day counterpart. And if this continues, then of course it's going to form a death cross, which implies a possible or signals a possible downtrend moving forward. So for me, it's still a wait and see mode.
Okay, let's not start catching the falling knives here. Let's talk about the big listing of today, Phil REIT, ending at the end at 7 pesos and 2 centavos. How does this performance in its debut tell you? What story does it tell you about the interest of investors? It was actually 8,000 retail investors. That's the most among listed REIT investment trusts so far. But you know, as you mentioned, there's still a lot of risks on the table. Is this a dividend yield they've projected for 2021, 6.3%, and 2022, 6.6%, going to be achievable given all of these risks on the table and possible lockdowns?
Well, with respect to FLI REIT, yes, investors are pricing in the risk. That's why we weren't able to see such a robust performance today. On the upside, yes, it has competitive dividend yields, and this is suitable for investors who are, you know, into the long, who are into dividend plays, who are looking for financial instruments where they can just preserve their capital. So this is a good venue for them. But the problem still, yes, there is the risk. There is the overall risk in the economy. And one of those which are heavily affected is the property sector. So do take note, well, with PhilREIT, it's heavily exposed with the BPO. And at the same time, it's also exposed with the POGO sector. And these are some of the sectors that are currently being hit by the overall economic condition of the country caused by the COVID-19 pandemic. So this is what investors are worrying in right now. That's why we didn't. FLI REIT's rise today was very much tempered. Investors are weighing the upside and downside. On the upside, yes, you do have a good dividend yield, but on the downside, the question is there: will you be able to deliver given the current economic conditions?